This is the gymnasium at Cal State University, Los Angeles, the scene of the judo competition. On this day, a dramatic story is coming to its conclusion. A story which had its beginning 7 years earlier and 6,000 miles away. This is a dojo in Hiratsuka, Japan. Here students practice the art of judo, a sport that was introduced to the Olympics at the Tokyo Games of 1964. The sport began a little over a century ago in Japan as a non-violent means of recreation and self-defense. Translated, judo means the gentle way. Pupils are taught a philosophy that emphasizes strength, technique, and concentration as opposed to violence. Judo players are told that yielding is strength. Gentle turns away sturdy. Bend like a bamboo, then strike back. This is Yasuhiro Yamashita, perhaps the greatest judo player in the history of the sport. Yamashita is a national hero in Japan. As the Los Angeles Games approach, Yamashita has a winning streak of 194 straight victories, undefeated over the last 7 years. During this period, he has won the All Japan Judo Championships 8 times and the World Championships 3 successive times. His opponents consider him unbeatable. Judo experts consider him invincible. Standing 5 feet 11 inches and weighing 280 pounds, Yamashita has one more goal.
I have wanted to win an Olympic gold medal ever since I was a child. I was very disappointed in 1980 when the boycott prevented me from competing in the Moscow Olympics. I am also very sad because there are many great champions who will not compete in Los Angeles for the same reason.
It is August 11th, 5 p.m. More than 4,000 spectators fill the arena for the Open Division Judo Championship. 3 Japanese have already won gold medals in lower weight classes. Changes in Olympic rules have prevented Yasuhiro Yamashita from winning 2 gold medals. In the past, it was possible for a judo player to compete in his weight division and then attempt to win the Open Division, regardless of his weight. Throughout his career, Yamashita has been besieged with offers to become a sumo wrestler and by Japanese promoters to enter professional wrestling. Offers that would have made him a wealthy man. His reply, "It is my lifetime desire to become Olympic champion." Yamashita's first opponent, Lansana Coley of Senegal. During Yamashita's string of 194 successive victories, he has scored 189 ippons, the equivalent in judo to a knockout in boxing or a pin in wrestling. So dominant is Yamashita in his sport. The question is, how long will an opponent last, rather than whether the opponent will win? Most of Yamashita's bouts are over in 30 seconds. Lansana Coley of Senegal is defeated in 27 seconds. One hour later, Yamashita faces Arthur Schnabel of West Germany. Victory in judo can be scored in several ways. The most spectacular, throwing an opponent onto his back with great force and impetus. If the referee decides that a throw is not of the highest quality, the match will continue. Victory can also be scored by pinning an opponent for 30 seconds, or if an opponent surrenders voluntarily. Finally, the inevitable. Schnabel signals his surrender. As Yamashita leaves the mat, he is limping and in pain.
During my match with Schnabel, I injured my right leg. It did not appear serious at the time. Nevertheless, I had to focus all my concentration on my opponent and the task at hand. As I left the arena, I knew my injury was more serious than I had originally thought.
At 6:45 in the evening, Yasuhiro Yamashita steps onto the mat for the semifinal bout. His limp is more pronounced, and there is concern in the Japanese camp. The injury to Yamashita's right leg is certain to affect his speed and mobility. Yamashita's opponent, Laurent Del Colombo of France. Del Colombo attacks Yamashita's injured leg. He throws Yamashita. but the referee rules the match should continue. Nevertheless, it is a rare moment in judo. Yamashita is in danger of losing. Yamashita throws Del Colombo. Again, the referee signals the bout to continue because the throw was not of the highest quality. Yamashita has now taken control. He holds Del Colombo to the mat. Yamashita wins. Now the most important match of his career. The one for the Olympic gold medal. He will meet Mohamed Rashwan of Egypt. Rashwan has won all three of his preliminary bouts decisively. All three have ended in victory by an ippon.
In my semifinal, it was the first time I ever thought I might lose. My opponent knew of my injury, but in judo, attacking an injury is considered part of the sport. If my opponent was injured, I would not change my strategy. Therefore, I prepared for a similar attack in the final.
Rashwan attacks the injured leg. So Yasuhiro Yamashita leaves the arena as he had entered. An unblemished record extending over 7 years. 198 successive victories. So the long journey of Yasuhiro Yamashita is over. And with it, the fulfillment of the philosophy of judo. Yielding is strength. Gentle turns away sturdy.